even see Xtal over the corner and dance by himself. He's so weird. Anyway, we're back and striving to make a difference with many hands, one project and one sign at a time. The Davina Bennett Foundation for the Deaf was founded. Davina, Mark, Brittany and Dorothy joins us now. So she's to my right because she has to be in front of Brittany for her to be able to translate. And of course we have Davina. How was it? 8 years ago, I had to play a deaf mute in a show and I had to learn minimal sign language. And I realized, because my director told me I could not speak, that was one of the hardest periods for me. I was not allowed to speak. So how has it been working with somebody who, that's their reality?
All right, for me, I currently train Brittany, she's a model. And when we first accepted Brittany on board, because Brittany is a part of Sway Caribbean Model Agency. And when I first accepted her on board, I was like, oh my gosh, how am I going to work this out? Because I don't know sign language. But what I did was use my own little gestures. So if I tell her, walk a little bit faster, I would.
Yeah.
But over time, you know, that's where the inspiration came from to build this foundation, because I was saying, you know what? I need to learn this.
I need to learn this because
since I've had like one class with her, it has made a big difference. I can sign my name, I can say my foundation name.
What do you know?
All right, I can say my name is. They've given me a sign to say instead
of
spelling
out first and then you get a sign to.
So my sign is D. That's my sign.
You got it. And she's loving it right now.
Right.
What is your connection to all of this?
Well, the foundation she's going to talk about now, it's a foundation that strives to bridge the gap between the general public and the deaf society. So I'm here to give a hint of what's to come.
You're the gap.
No, I'm a part of the foundation aiming towards that goal.
Okay, and why do you think we need to have deaf or hearing impaired people integrated into society as opposed to just being a group that is segregated from everybody? Why do you think we need to have them integrated?
I think we need to have them integrated because not because they are deaf or they're hearing impaired means that they cannot function the way we do. The things that we do, they can do it as well.
Of course.
And I don't think that we need to separate them and put them in this box and call them names, because you know, our small-minded people tend to think that they're dummies and they're not normal or they cannot function independently. People will go as far as to ask, can they text? Can they read?
Yeah.
You know?
I remember people actually calling me dummy when I did that. And I remember how painful it was for me. And I don't have to suffer through that every day.
Right.
Brittany, good morning. How has it been for you these past, well, how long have you been modeling, first of all?
I came from training, modeling. I saw it on a movie. I want to improve my life, and I also think that it is good for deaf people. Not because we are deaf, we need to be integrated into society. It is fair.
Yeah, it's definitely fair. It's more than fair.
We need to be involved in the things of the world. Deaf people can do things well. They can act, we can do drama, we can model, we can do things.
Well, as a model, have you been enjoying the process? What has it been like for you? Oh, yes. What's it been like? What's your favorite part?
I feel also excited. It is interesting walking on the runway. It just motivates me. I'm excited. I feel loved. You know, I do different things and it's so exciting.
How do you manage to not miss a beat? Because I've been told that you are fantastic on a runway. How do you manage to make sure that you keep your beat and your pace?
Well, I know that I have to stand the proper way because Navita taught me how to walk. I have to be careful not to walk off the walk straight like I'm walking on a line. And I have to keep my expression and my smile.
Smile is there.
Yeah.
So, Davina, yes. In terms of what your plans are to get them integrated, what's up? What's for the next couple of months? What do you
All right, for the next couple of months, we are going to develop an app.
Well, we're aiming to
develop an app. That's okay. The app. That's the aim, sorry.
And what is the app supposed to do?
Mark.
Well, the app, everybody I tell about app, I tell them that you can teach a person that's not deaf. Well, you can't teach a deaf person to talk, but you can definitely teach a person who is not deaf how to sign. So the app came about to get awareness to the general public or teach the general public how to sign, so they're better able to accommodate or not accommodate, but it's a bridge between the general public and the deaf society.
In terms of forcing someone who's hearing impaired to try and live in our world, we need to meet at a point where we can all.
Yeah, a compromise.
Right.
So it's a bridge.
And one more exciting thing that is definitely in the planning is we're planning to have we're aiming towards having an inclusive 5K walk run to bring awareness. In Jamaica, we want everybody on board because, you know, this has never been done
before
in the sense that we have one specifically for the Deaf Society.
Okay, before we have to go, because we really do have to go now, where can we reach you to get more information on
that? So you can reach us on our Facebook page, which is the Davina Bennett Foundation for the Deaf, and our Instagram page at Davina Bennett Foundation.
Fantastic. So, thank you guys so much for stopping by. And I look forward to seeing that app. So make sure you send it to me because I want to know. All right. Founder of the DBA for the Deaf, Davina Bennett. Face of the foundation, Brittany Barnes. Fantastic model. And interpreter, Dorothy Williams. Stay with us. We've got the second video pick of the week up after the break.